Everyone, welcome back to Legend BTV, and 2018 is finally here. Before we close our books on 2017, let's discuss, in my opinion, the best music this year had to offer. That's right, my top 50 favorite songs of 2017. 2017 as a whole, unfortunately, even in underground music, just wasn't as good as 2016 was to me. I still found many gems, don't get me wrong, like you're about to see on this list, but I feel like I just found much more incredible music in last year than this year, which I'm actually going to be going back and making a top 50 over last year. So guys, get hyped for that. Yeah, this year just left a little bit to be desired for me, because even some of my favorite acts from the last couple of years just managed to disappoint me. Although I'm a little underwhelmed by the year as a whole, that doesn't mean there's not some fantastic songs that definitely deserve the spotlight. I really hope to introduce you to what I feel is some awesome music. So guys, if you have a friend who loves music, or just anybody who loves music in general, share them my playlist here, and share this video to them and just get everybody watching this and hopefully introduce them to some good music you may not have heard this year. The rules are quite simple. The song had to be released as a 2017 single or part of a 2017 album to qualify. Basically, any 2017 song. With that out of the way, let's get going with the top 50 best songs of 2017! Before we get into that special list, here is a long list of honorable mentions. Just so many great songs that were close to making the list, just not quite. We don't have to hurt no more.
I was up a late night balling, so far from my past misfortune.
So long, so nice to know ya, nice to know ya. I'm sorry to say, I'm sorry to say,
hey baby, this is who I am. I shouldn't have to say it for you to understand, cause you already got me in the palm of your hand.
You keep your promises no more, saying you'll be home by 12 from strolling in at 4.
Should not come in home with me tonight.
You just want attention, you don't want my heart, baby.
Cause baby, when you're gone, all you dance is rain.
And it feels like, oh, 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 oh.
The rocks that they keep throwing are the ones that built my dreams.
And now, the list.
I need to know everything about you. I feel it. I feel it.
Tiesto kicked off 2017 by releasing his After Hours project, and it had some excellent songs in there. This is definitely one of them. The song is catchy, energetic, fun, and definitely perfect for any festival. The melody here is very potent, the vocals are very solid, and especially that verse they throw in there, that part is just incredible. It is a little bit low, unfortunately, because as much as I can vibe with this song, it is very repetitive, and it's a little bit too repetitive at times, so I really need to be in the mood for this one, but when I am and it clicks, it turns into a really great song. Still, definitely check this one out.
Girl, my self-control so paralyzed. When it comes to you, no, I ain't got no patience.
My God, I did not expect this from Thomas Red. From start to finish, this song is just awesome. The song starts off with a bang, with these roaring guitars kicking in. And admittedly, the mix sounds a little muffled with the bass and the guitars and all those sounds together. But it still just manages to sound just really awesome. The drums, especially in the verses, pack a punch too. Thomas Rhett just kills those verses, honestly. You can tell the song's very genuine, although unfortunately, it's not lyrically complex or really all that great. I can't really go into much of these lyrics because you pretty much know it's a sex song. But still, it's so catchy and memorable and just amazing to me. This should have been bigger than it was. And yeah, that's kind of sad, but Maren Morris doesn't get too much time to shine here. That's a little sad, but hey, she does a great job with the backing vocals, and her and Thomas Rhett blend together tremendously. Excellent job. I would like to see more of this in the future, but I'll take this for now. Ah, the big Nickelodeon band's Big Time Rush's solo projects are probably some of the most slept-on pop acts I've seen this decade. This debut song from Logan shows a different side of him, but it's definitely a great one. The light electric guitar touches provide a nice groove to the track. The beat is strong, and Logan just provides some excellent vocals here. Overall, it's a nice, sexy, well-produced pop song. Really great track, and if you love BTR back in the day, you should definitely know that they do have solo music out there, and this should be big.
Drugs and candy.
Okay, I'm gonna warn you, some of the picks on this list are definitely controversial, and this is one of them. Last Young Renegade as an album managed to disappoint pretty much almost every critic except for me. I actually really enjoyed that record, and this song is no exception. Admittedly, the song is less dynamic than previous All Time Low releases, but oh my God, I cannot deny that chorus is phenomenal. The way Alex sings drugs and candy, like that, I don't know. For me, that just like, that is such an earworm, and I love it. Like, the way the vocals echo each other, and just like, oh God, just the drums pounding, and I don't know, guys, I love this. Maybe you will too, maybe you won't, I don't care. Next song. What the last song lacked in dynamics, this one certainly won't. This song is just very colorful and vibrant, with the vivid electronic synth layering, the calm, breezy vocals, and just the overall serene feel of this track. It was definitely an excellent start to Lainey's debut album. And although unfortunately Lainey's debut got kind of boring towards the end, this one definitely starts the album out with a bang, and I couldn't be happier.
No distraction, no distraction.
To me, Beck's Colors was admittedly a pretty cool album. A lot of the songs were huge earworms to me, and this is no exception. No Distraction has incredibly catchy guitar rhythms, Beck's great performance, and it's so catchy and groovy. It's, oh my God, amazing. After 13 albums, Beck proves that he still has it. Excellent song. Definitely check this out.
And it's paradise in our minds, falling together, arms around each other, I know you.
So, Craig David has a new album coming out. The UK superstar singer teamed up with Bastille for one of his singles here, and it is awesome. Dan and Craig just sound incredible over this trap production that sounds incredibly full and thick. Then it transitions to a bass-heavy trap section, and then a spacious melody in the background, and then those crisp snaps, and it all just sounds really awesome. The US should have really picked this one up. It's sad, really, nobody gives Craig David a chance here in the US, or really Bastille after Pompeii.
Living the good life full of goodbyes. My eyes are on the gray sky, saying I don't want to come home tonight.
Khalid has just been like pretty much the rising star of 2017. And American Teen is basically just the best song on there for me. The vibrant synth pop melody, The smooth flow, the colorful production, just the song is excellent. Just all the 80s synthwave influences, and I don't know. Location and Young, Dumb, and Broke were never bad songs. Since I feel like they just were a little safe and like catered for the radio, while like other songs like this really explode and are colorfully dynamic, and those two songs really just aren't. But yeah, anyways, this one is awesome, so definitely check this out if you haven't heard Khalid's full album. The title track is excellent.
Well, to touch you like a hand grenade, you touch me like a razor blade. I wish there was some.
This song is just awesome. I love the energy of this track. I love the vocals of this track. I love the key of this track. The sound is energetic, and yet the lyrics are vivid and with lines like, I'll hold you like a hand grenade, you touch me like a razor blade. Okay, as cheesy as that sounds in theory, when it clicks, this is truly a rockin' track, and yeah, just, I love it.
Big city, beautiful sky, the only thing I want is to say
bye. Oh my god, Kung's dropped an excellent remix of Don't You Know this year. The sound of the song changes almost completely, but it's just such an excellent change. The new trumpet melody in this song sounds awesome. It sounds incredibly earwormy. Jamie in Commons is like the perfect vocalist for this beat. Of course, you can't forget the vocal harmonizing in the beginning. Jamie's smooth, sexy delivery is so potent against this catchy as heck beat. I'm not sure if this is better than the remix or not. It really just kind of depends what mood I am in, but still, this song is awesome. Okay, I'll admit right out of the gate, this track really doesn't have the most incredible lyrics ever, but the production here certainly is great. The piano melody is powerful, catchy, colorful, and admittedly, while the acoustics do feel a little muffled, and the song can feel a bit too sugary at times, lacking in substance, it's still, when it clicks, it's just a pleasure to hear for me. Especially in the verses where the guitars get grittier and the delivery gets fiercer. When he sings the lines, turn those speakers up till they break, cause every time you smile, it's a fake. Honestly, that part, just, the guitars get noticeably grittier, not really, like, incredibly grittier, but just that nice change where, like, they really strum them harder and everything, and yeah, I just love that part. Just all the little elements make this song the best song on an otherwise utterly disappointing Arcade Fire album.
Castles glitter under Spanish skies, but I'm just looking out for you.
Speaking of disappointments, Kygo really let me down with his sophomore album, to be honest. Despite this, this song is the one that wowed me. A beautiful piano line, incredibly potent melody, and Ryan Tedder just sounding excellent here against this beat. It all just turns into definitely the best song on Kids in Love, and one of the only Kygo sounding songs here. Yeah, that's a problem. This track is truly something great, although it is a little bit of a departure, once again, from AVB's traditional trance roots, and it's really poppy and a little commercial sounding. It's still just incredible. A well-produced electronic pop song with the pianos and then the catchy snaps, leading into more dramatic, more darker, but bouncier production getting into the verses, Garibay's soulful delivery, and then an incredible bouncy drop leading into the chorus, and then that final part towards the end, the big lead up, is incredible. And if you've seen the video, it's just like, it's really all, everything's living in the moment, and I don't know, it's fun, it's catchy, but it's also deep and meaningful too at the same time. It's hard to really pinpoint what exactly about the song makes it so awesome, but yeah, I pretty much said all I can here, so next. If you all remember, I did love Odessa's third album, A Moment Apart. The melodies really shine through on this track, the harmonizing and the pitch-shifted vocal sounds incredible on this track, even though this song might not be for everybody, but honestly for me, this, the electronic beauty of this song, it's really euphoric, really just, it's so colorful, and I don't even know. It's epic, honestly, this track is epic, and that's about all I have to say about it. As a huge Galanis fan, The Aviary also seemed like a disappointing sellout, similar to Kygo's Kids in Love 2, basically the EDM pop trends of 2017, and unfortunately, I didn't find much to make my list. That said, this song is still epic. The vocals are so in your face, especially on that chorus, in a good way, and the production is light but beautiful, and the drop is still solid. Definitely the best song on the Aviary, and it's a shame that album didn't turn out to be so great. Hopefully you guys find your way again on your third album. Hopefully.
We were opposite lovers. You kept trying to prove me wrong. And I know that I...
This song starts off awesome with the pianos and the heavy bass building up to these acoustics dropping in. And then the chorus is just really catchy as well. In general, it's a fun pop song about a relationship where everything didn't go right and she just wants him back, or her, or I don't know the sexuality of it all, but in general, yeah, nothing much to say. It's solid, fun, likable. Check it out.
So high up the mountain, I heard. I'm made out of plastic, I heard. You touched down in the face of my fears.
Sampa sounds to me like a pretty promising artist. This is my favorite song off of his debut album, Process. The song is beautiful with his light electronic guitar melodies. Sampa's incredibly melodic and light delivery. The chorus is beautiful here. It's not too big. It's not trying to be more than it actually is. It's just smooth, easy listening, calm, but yet beautiful and so melodically interesting that, yeah, this is just so memorable to me. Great song. Very interesting Coldplay song. The production here is very atmospheric and beautiful, especially around that chorus. The percussion is catchy as hell. There's a lot of interesting production choices, and it sounds incredibly dynamic, complex. Just pretty much a lot of things that I like about Coldplay, especially their newest style. It's just so complex and interesting. Although some may call this overdone, I just feel like all the elements thrown together make this song very atmospheric, very vibrant, full of character. Just, it's a characteristic song, especially Chris Martin's vocals in that chorus are just incredible. Definitely an excellent song, definitely check this out. Now this song should have been a pop hit. I know Beck's probably way past his time, but this song is fun, it's catchy, it's upbeat, it's poppy enough, and all around excellent. The bridge is awesome and gritty, and the part where the instrumentation strips back and he's just like, I just wanna stay up, I just wanna stay up all night with you. Okay, whatever. But yeah, that part's awesome. I don't know, it's very simple and basic in its lyrical messages, but all the complex instrumentation here just makes this a pretty epic pop tune.
Right here, right now, is all we need. Relax your mind and set it free. Be all you got, be all I see.
Okay, a lot of people don't like this song, and I definitely would understand why. The chorus is incredibly repetitive and repeats throughout most of the entire song, aside from one verse repeated twice. But my god, I'd be lying if I said Alesso didn't kill it with this beat. This beat is excellent. It is so catchy, so full of bass and melody. And the performance fits this song incredibly well. Just a sexy, smooth performance over this really great, catchy beat. And oh my god. It's a new style for Alesso, so naturally you would probably expect some mixed critical reception, which this song definitely did get. Some people loved it, some people hated it. For me, I definitely love it, although I will say, unfortunately, I was disappointed in his next single, Is That For Me, which I felt like was a pale imitation of this song. So unfortunately, that sucks, but hey, maybe he'll come around next time and maybe drop a new album or something in 2018 to wow me again. But hey, until then, this song is awesome. Thank you, Alesso. Man, just what a happy and energetic song this is. Honestly, it's just so likable. And whenever that chorus comes on, that bombastic, fun, full of energy chorus, I can't help but sing along. I honestly could see this being a brother to Shut Up and Dance. It honestly kind of has the same sound-ish. It kind of has similar styles, and the vocalist is fun, energetic, and the song just makes me happy like that one does.
Pull up on your block and break it down. We playing Tetris. AM to the PM, PM to the AM phone. Piss out your per diem.
All right, this song is fantastic, but you all already know that.
Keep him satisfied.
Okay, guys, SZA's Control was already a solid album with some great songs on it, but pairing her with Calvin Harris? Genius. His groovy, pounding funk beats, compared with SZA's beautiful, emotion, passionate delivery, create something just incredible. It's got a sweet melody too, and the slow yet powerful production really just sells this track for me. SZA is such an awesome singer, and this kind of funk track really, it fits her vocals really well. So, The Weeknd is an excellent song. So, Liam Gallagher of Oasis dropped his solo project this year, and this is definitely the best song on it. It's got a smooth, passionate, genuine delivery here about just the sorrows and losses that come with just losing your way, everything like that, and it's a sad song, but it's a great one too. There's some nice grungy rock guitars in there, and it's just an awesome rock ballad from a great artist. The debut album was pretty good. I wouldn't say it was quite amazing. It didn't really blow me away. But this song definitely did, though. It's beautiful. Check this out.
Give me a new single, make me a new baby, gonna eat all the candy while you're straddling lame.
Sylvanesso is one of the artists I discovered this year in 2017 that I've never heard of before. And I checked out their album, What Now? This is the song that stood out to me most on that album. Man, this song is just incredible. The smartness, the sassiness it plays as it parodies the life of pop stars and hit music and how it's all just incredibly commercial and contrived. Just, it's genius. I'm surprised more people don't do this because, like, honestly, they have every right to brag. They have one of the most melodic and dynamic sounds on this song I have heard this year. Honestly, I mean, I'm gushing about this one, but geez. This song is so melodic, it's so captivating, so full of character, energy, it's unique. The performer has a lot of charisma, and just, you could feel that sassiness in her, but it's likable sassiness. It's not like Meghan Trainor, but yeah, it's likable, it's great. Definitely check this one out, that's all I'm saying. Talking about disappointments once again, we do have to talk about the newest record from Starset. It was pretty underwhelming. Not bad per se, but just kind of underwhelming. It's just, yeah, not all the songs really stuck out to me, but this one definitely did. The fun space rock vibe and the way the electronics clash with the metal instruments towards the chorus and the breakdown of this song is just genius. Just full of atmosphere and character. Honestly, it's a creative, fun, cool track, and even if you're not a Starset fan, I would say give this one a listen.
Dirty laundry is piling in her room. She's got her secrets.
Hey, controversial opinions continue with this track. I'll admit, I had to grow into this one, but when I did, I realized just how incredible of a pop track this is. The song pretty much surrounds a relationship in where the girl obviously has a lot of dirty laundry, meaning like secrets she's hiding, or like maybe she's a cheater or something like that. Just stuff she's been doing that just really isn't right. But he doesn't care because the dirty laundry looks good on her. Like, you know, he still loves her anyway. So honestly, yeah, it's a pretty easy message to figure out. Yeah, overall, the vocals are really the main selling point of this track though. Alex just kills it again. Honestly, he's a great vocalist and really what made Last Young Renegade for me. And in general, just a kick butt track, and the guitar solo at the end is just phenomenal. Honestly, when the guitars pick up at the end, it's phenomenal. But even that chorus is great as well. Honestly, definitely check this one out.
When she leaves my side,
Encore by DJ Snake was probably one of my biggest EDM letdowns of 2016. It was just such an underwhelming record, trying too many different EDM styles and really only half-baking each concept. So yeah, it really let me down. But Here Comes the Night featuring Mr. Hudson was definitely the best song on it, and this remix may be even better than the original. Lots of cool production choices added to this track. Definitely the second drop is what guaranteed it a spot on this list. Go ahead, check this track out, listen to the second drop on it. You will not regret it. It is awesome.
Anyone can see, anyone can see your hiding, hiding. You can talk to me.
Niall Horan's Flicker turned out to be a surprisingly solid folk rock record. It definitely had its fair share of great songs, and this is one of them. The beautiful acoustic instrumentation of this track, the smooth, sultry vocals from Niall, And just the fact that it's just so peaceful, and the fact that since they're alone, she can show him all about her. And unfortunately, while I do think that's pretty much leaning more towards, hey, since we're alone, let's have sex. But no, imagine if it was actually just a genuine feeling of like, hey, since you're being alone with somebody, it's like, you know, you feel free. You feel like you can actually trust them. You feel like you can actually have a genuine conversation and say what's actually on your mind without having to worry about the unfortunate judging of somebody or something. Because Niall Horan seems like a sweet guy, so I don't know. He just seems like a nice guy to me, so. Yeah, but anyways, though, either way, this song is awesome. And honestly, it's a beautiful track. So yeah, if you haven't already noticed already on my list, James Maslow dropped one of the best and yet most slept on pop records of the year. A pop record that, yes, tried the trends of 2017, but also presented some dark, edgy sounds and wasn't afraid to take risks and be cool. This song is just amazing. With the beginning line like, I remember when you caught my eye, must have played it back 1,000 times. Revealing right off the bat that this song is about the incredible feeling that you get when you see a girl for the first time and you know she's the one you want. And the way he sells that with such genuine delivery, I'm just like, oh my god, like that is just, it's heavenly, man. Like that first part of the song there. And let's not forget the harmonizing on the chorus when that drops in. That is just incredible. Honestly, with more promotion, James Maslow could be a star. Next year, let's make that happen, because this is phenomenal.
Put that spotlight on her face.
Kicking off our top 20, we actually have a song that was a pretty decent sized hit. Yeah, that's pretty much made it on here because I listened to this song probably more than any other hit song this year, and that's for good reason. It's catchy, it's got a lot of replay value, it's memorable, it's a lot of fun. Migos are a lot of fun on this. Calvin Harris's production is bouncy, fun, and of course the echoey claps are incredible still. It's got a good melody, it's got a good drop at the beginning, and what can I say, it's still just awesome. So thank you, Calvin Harris. It is a great introduction to your sound, and you're amazing. Side note, though, this is also the song that got me 21,000 views on my review, despite it being one of the laziest, worst things I've ever done on this channel. But hey, thank you all for getting that to 21,000 views, whoever saw that. Next song.
So I surrender. This is the moment I surrender.
This production is probably some of the most dark, deep, and beautiful Walk the Moon songs I've ever heard. The dark pianos, Nick's powerful performance, and the bouncy beat, and then like how it enables to just transition into just like this piano with all this atmosphere, and the layering on it is just great. And in general, if you were disappointed by the sound change of What If Nothing, I would definitely say go back and give this one a listen. If you forgot everything else, definitely this one. It won me over, and it's great.
Singing home, blowing that day.
Ah yes, the XX put out a great record with I See You, and this song is probably my favorite on it. It's got an incredibly potent melody. It's soft, but it's also catchy, full of energy, and it's also got a minimalist vibe. And the vocalist, the male vocalist, sounds like Andrew Taggart, you know, if he actually gave a damn. Just a really sweet song, and the whoa-ohs on this song are awesome. Yeah, beautiful song.
Make a phone to my chest.
Broadcast the boom, 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 and make them all dance.
Coming in at number 17, we got Lord, and Lord's Melodrama was one of the most potent, one of the most personal records of the year, and this song is one of my favorites on it. Beautiful vocals, deep, dark production, and Lord effervescently carries this chorus into new levels of awesome. Who knew Lord could just get this great, honestly? Like, so awesome. Foo Fighters made a solid rock album this year with Concrete and Gold, and their lead single, Run, it was just awesome. Honestly, I say that a lot for these songs, and I'm sorry, but this is how I describe it. They're just awesome songs, guys. And this is no exception. The grungy vocals, the pounding drums on this thing, the incredible solo it builds up to around the 4-minute mark, And in general, just a hypnotic track that's like, it's really grungy, really gritty, really catchy at the same time. It's like, it's poppy, it's rocky, and everything else, and it's a lot of things, and yeah, it's just energetic, fun, and a feel-good song. Andrew McMahon's attempt at an upbeat EDM song works really well. The drop has an infectious, earwormy melody to it that will have you humming all day. The vocals are really good here, and it's just not one of those everyday songs. I guess that's what I like most about it. It's just a weird, unique song. Seriously, the title is Shot Out of a Cannon? Honestly, I'm just like, whoa, that song sounds like just such an awesome song already by the title of that. Fantastic song, by far blows away for the best song on Zombies on Broadway. Get it? Blows away. Like a cannon? I know, I'll stop. Oh yes! This is what I like. Upbeat, funky, disco-style music with just the main goal in mind is to have fun. So many songs today have the trend of wanting to sound really sad and reveling in all that depression and sadness and thinking they're making everybody feel better by relating to them, and only ending up making matters worse and making this world seem more like a cruel, just dark hole of a place instead of, you know, the fun, upbeat, uplifting, positive place that it could be if we all just believe in ourselves. And this song really makes us feel that with one of the jazziest disco-esque beats this year, and just full of character and flavor. Like, honestly, this song is something special, guys, and it's prepare to dance is all I'm saying. Just have fun.
Sunny days, lift me when I'm down.
Speaking of songs just oh so happy to be alive, we get another EDM song from Armin van Buuren. This time AVB provides some late spring vibes with some breezy cool guitars, floating against the verses against Josh Kumbi's smooth, beautiful delivery on this song, and the positive uplifting message on when there's sunny days, it makes him feel better than the cloudy days, obviously. And of course, there's probably another message to that. Obviously, though, it's just like, yeah, sunny days in general make me feel better than cloudy days too, so I kind of relate to that. But anyways though, the melody is awesome, it's got a cool drop, and just the vocals are beautiful, and like, I don't know, it's just, oh man, it's great. Joywave is an alternative rock band that I discovered on SiriusXM's Alt Nation this year, and this song is definitely a joy. Honestly, it's such a nice surprise to hear a song like this. The twangy guitar progressions in the verses, leading up to this heavy rock feel in the chorus. Not overly heavy, but just kind of like, it just turns into a big rock song then. Honestly, the vocalist sounds nice. There's a lot of interesting production choices all throughout this song. And yeah, honestly, it's just fantastic.
In my head, I do everything right. When you call, I've forgiven that fight.
This song is interesting. It starts off slow and light, but then transitions into this catchy pop jam. And Lord, of course, just kills her verses and the chorus, of course. Yeah, the song is funky, upbeat, catchy, and dark and slow at the same time. It's just a lot of things. Very dynamic and complex song. And overall, it's just great. Lord just killed it with melodrama, and this song is easily the best song on it.
Oops, I did it again. I forgot what I was losing my mind.
Hey! What? Was that necessary? Okay, sure. I've got some splaining to do. This is one of the most hated songs of the year, and a lot of critics have trashed this song, and even fans of the song have been underwhelmed and disappointed by this song. And honestly, I love it. Yeah, that's right. I don't just like this song, I freaking love it. Everything about this weird, mishmashy, just awkward as heck song just works so well for me. The vocals are gold. The drum buildup, gold. Even the chorus with the pitch shifting chipmunks. Freaking music to my ears. The song fits the theme of the album title, Mania, incredibly well. There's a lot going on here. A lot of like drum breaks, a lot of punchy production, a lot of trap snares, which unfortunately is like another trend hopping kind of thing. But still, disregarding that, the chipmunks are awesome too. They provide a nice little melody to the song and just add so much to the layering of this song. It's a very complex song, which I've been saying for a lot of these songs here. But yeah, it's very complex. It's very interesting. The verses are really calm. And then like the buildup is like this huge drum buildup. And honestly, like the drums sound awesome with the little like the little twinkling melody going on after each drum beat, if you notice. That's awesome too. And in general, just all the little things about the song combined together just make it great. And even though I could see that chorus getting very grating, which it already has on a lot of people, I'm just like, hey, I love it, to be honest. It's powerful and it's great. Honestly, I just really respect the band's risks to this song. And they didn't play it safe with more middle-of-the-road pop rock music for the radio. And just more tired, stale stuff like that from American Beauty, American Psycho. I'm so glad they actually took a risk this time. And that risk worked so well for me, though. Honestly, guys, I'm sorry. I mean, I like this song. I like what I like, okay? I'm sorry. You guys are probably thinking, man, this guy has a trash taste in music. I like what I like. This is my video. If you don't like it, make your own. Okay, this song may catch you off thinking this is just an ordinary, basic pop song. In theory, you're kind of right. It has all the elements of a pop song. But in general, Zara Larsson's delivery, though, is one of the best deliveries I've heard this year. Full of nuance, full of color, full of emotion. And especially when she harmonizes towards the end and the beat swells up and gets bigger, more energetic, and just more fun. Honestly, the song is beautiful. The pianos are incredibly textured. It's a well-produced pop song, but that's not even it. It would be like an okay pop song if it wasn't for Zara Larsson's like incredible delivery. Seriously, she is awesome. This song is freaking phenomenal. SZA just sounds incredible here, and the beat is just so fantastic. It is full of color, full of vibrant energy, and my god, SZA just sounds amazing here. Like, I can't get over it, like, how incredible this song is. I have no words for this pick, but hey, SZA rocks. Check this one out. The Killers are on here with the best song from Wonderful Wonderful, and this song definitely is killer. I know. The part where he sings Call My Name, and then like all the synthesizers come in and create this synthetic yet beautiful melody going on, like that's just like ear heaven, basically. I don't know if that's even a real word, but you know, that's just how great Into the Depths of Greatness we're getting, guys. This track is phenomenal, the way it builds up into like this powerful rock anthem and starts from like this little kind of rock ballady kind of song into like this huge anthemic chorus with a lot of drums and him just howling away at those vocals. Guys, this is like rock you don't get more often. I wish the Killers were still really popular like they were a decade ago, because that's kind of sad they aren't as popular, because I got into a lot of their songs this year, and like Mr. Brightside, When We Were Young, those are like rock classics, man. But well, they will be in about 30 years, but you know what I mean. Like, you know, 2000s rock classics, but of course they're not like the 80s rock. You know what I mean? Yeah, whatever. Next song.
Tell me I don't care. Tell me I never tried. I said I'm sorry. Maybe a million.
Okay, here we go. The final of what I consider to be controversial picks. But my god, this is like probably one of the best pop songs of the year. It's like, it's synthetic, it is incredibly overly produced. I get any kind of criticism you may have against Maroon 5 here, but this song, I couldn't help but to put it on the list. I've listened to this song a lot throughout the year, and I mean, they've sold out a long time ago. They've probably lost a lot of their, you know, freshness, a lot of their, like, you know, just everything. They're probably way past their prime, but my god, they still make some incredibly catchy pop tunes. And this song is on here just pretty much best basically because of how much it hooks me in, honestly. It kicks off Red Pill Blues with a freaking bang, and My God, Adam on that bridge is incredible. There is so much melody going on. You really wouldn't expect that kind of stuff from a Maroon 5 song, but like, yeah, it's so different. And the R&B texture focusing more on Adam's voice, I'm like, hey, thank you, because like, Adam sounds incredible here, guys. I don't know. Adam Levine is just a fantastic singer to me, honestly. Like, I mean, I don't know why. I like him. I don't know why. Next song. Alright, welcome to another incredible rock song. The Menzingers are another band I figured out this year, and Lookers is honestly a fantastic song. The part at the beginning where it sounds more raw and it sounds less, you know, overproduced and auto-tuned is incredible, and then it leads into this catchy, punchy guitar riff with one of the catchiest guitar hooks I've heard this year. Honestly, it's that part right there where it starts like after the main beginning with the chorus, and the verses are phenomenal here. A song about reminiscing in the past and how you felt when you were both lookers, just, you know, young, great-looking people, and how you fell in love for the first time. Just basically a beautiful rock track, really anthemic, really powerful, and yeah, just excellent job, guys. The best song off of Beck's Colors, by far. Honestly, the title track starts this thing off with a bang. Full of life, full of color. Actually, it is so freaking refreshing, honestly. It does kind of sound like that trend of the chopped up choruses and all the vocal loops and everything and all that kind of stuff. And while that may sound gratuitous and old to you, honestly, for me, this one is just done so much more better. The execution is flawless throughout this song. The chorus has a lot of punch to it, and it's just so catchy, and the woodwind instruments flowing throughout. See, I don't know what the heck I'm even saying, but this song is just excellent. Beck just still has that energy, that firepower to really sell these catchy, more upbeat hooks for him. And I'm like, hey, I'm glad he's back, because he's awesome. Cut Copy released a really incredible and euphoric track this year, and this song is just incredible. The vocals blend so well with the melody that it makes you just want to cry. And like, dear God, the melody on this song, the line, you gotta give up the things you love to make it better. I don't know, that part always just like, it's so perfect, the way the melody sounds in this song. We're just getting to where it's so good, I can't even think of adjectives to come up with anything better than the rest of the list, because like, this list is already getting so great. I'm just like, oh God. And yet we're only at number 3. There's still 2 more songs to go. Oh my God. The creativity and electronica in this song has just basically been unmatched almost all throughout this year. This song is so freaking dynamic, and it is beautiful in parts. Like, when you get to like the best parts of this song, it is incredible, mesmerized. The closing part of this song, it really makes you think. Electronic music can be really beautiful when used creatively, and this is definitely one of those moments, guys. Do not pass this track up. It is phenomenal, easily the best song off of Odessa's A Moment Apart, and for good reason, guys. This should have been a single, this should have been a song that got a little more traction from Odessa fans, and I don't know, for me, it's easily Odessa's best song so far. So, keep it up, guys. This is phenomenal. Alright, before we get to number 1, I have a bonus song for you guys. Yeah, a song apparently that I was going to put on this list, but then I forgot, and I already had the script done, and I'm like, eh, whatever. So I'm gonna include it on this list anyway, show you another song. And this song probably would have been really high up because it is a fantastic song. Yeah, not much to say here, guys, except this song is beautiful. The way voices harmonize with each other, the guitar melody, the piano, the light percussion, and especially the chorus towards the end where everything just picks up and there's a lot more weight to it, and it gets more heavy and interesting. And yeah, guys, this song is beautiful in every sense of the word. And I know you're probably all just like, what the heck is your number 1 by now? But I'm getting to it, all right? yes, the moment you've all been waiting for. This is my number one song, Pierce Fulton's Home in August. This song is just euphoric, guys. This song is such a sweet melody, such an incredible drop on this song. It is so freaking catchy. My God, I'm just baffled how good this is. Like, this song from start to finish is just perfect. An instrumental EDM cut with so much happiness, so much life, so much color. All the adjectives I've used throughout this video pretty much describe this song and in its entirety from start to finish. There's nothing wrong with this song at all. There's no low points. Honestly, it's all just high points. The breakdowns are catchy. The verses, if you want to call them that, they're just like vocals just singing random noises. But still, it's sung in such a beautifully done way against the beat. And that ending, man, it is beautiful too. It's a beautiful closure to this song and this list. And honestly, I mean, I couldn't think of a better way for this list to go out. Honestly, if there's one track you listen to all throughout, it's definitely got to be this one, guys. Definitely check this one out in its entirety, because although I can only show you a 10-second preview thanks to YouTube's copyright system, I want to show you this whole thing because it is incredible, guys. Definitely go check out that song. It's something special. It's truly special, guys. And honestly, the first time I heard this, I was like, whoa, this is incredible. I mean, I couldn't believe what I was hearing, honestly. I don't know why. I got so emotional hearing that. And it's an instrumental EDM cut. You're thinking, what the heck? But I don't know, man. It's great. Well, guys, that was a long ride. But hey, I mean, we made it through. These are all my 50 favorite songs of the year. Yeah, guys, feel free to check any of them out. Feel free to subscribe to my channel. Feel free to share this video with other people. Like, comment your thoughts down below. Comment disagreements. Comment your favorite songs of the year. And anyways, I am out. More videos are coming soon. Thank you all for watching. I appreciate it greatly.